Well, meanwhile, the families of women who were brutally murdered in Nakulabye and their bodies burnt by suspected killer Musa Musasizi today stormed the police demanding for the bodies of their loved ones. Now they claim it's over a month since the government promised to hand over these bodies and nothing has so far been done. We have this report.
The Bita families are all residents of Kampala Central, Makere Industrial Area Village in Kagugube Parish. Patrick Kaguma, the uncle to the late Violet Kansime, who was killed together with her three-month baby Abigail Nachtende, explained that it's over a month and they are not seeing the bodies of their people, even after getting an assurance from police.
Due to the time lag, these people were killed on 13th and got the information on 24th. And since that time, so got the information. Really, it's like they are seeing there's some inefficiency somewhere, but the government is doing its best to give us our bodies.
A 23-year-old Musa Musasizi, a resident of Nakulabye, who is under custody, is said to have killed three women and a three-month-old baby, burnt their bodies and later dumped them in the areas of Nakulabye. Police arrested Musasizi last month and promised to hand over the bodies of the deceased to the families, but up to date, this has never been fulfilled. Kasim Luwoa Musisi, the LC1 chairperson of Makere Industrial Area in Kagugube Parish, was forced to intervene. He gave an assurance to this family that police was working around the clock.
Gano ge maka gomwala pansimo we yali asula. Eya ino mwana bwacha ali mukuteka teka oluvanyima nga government emaliriza wejjo tuwa omwero kumala okukebera DNA.
The CID spokesperson Charles Twine explained the delay, asking the aggrieved families to be calm.
So this particular case, there were some reasons which were very specific. First of all, is that one of the dead bodies was the precursor. It was the first body that was seen, the body that was killed on 22nd February 2021. And this was a body of some lady called Hereza Makiri. Now, the uniqueness of this case is that it was severely burnt, burnt almost to no recognition. But the kind of the debris that had remained there made it extremely very hard for our experts to draw blood, which blood they would actually extract the DNA for profiling. Now,
abantu bandi bubagamba bagala muntu tebamulaba bakoyo okusula wabweru abamu amayumba bagaggala basula wange wano ne mukyalo bamubona abamu bakaddayo era nga balinze bakoya abamu bava mukono abamu bava foti nibabandi bakola ki nibadde none omugana wange naye tabeere nabeera mukyalo naye yajja lwakunkuma ekyo ekizibu kyenaye ku mulimu si kyakola bagenda nakungoma amanyi siina era nsaba bannyambe.
This story was compiled by Juliet Namoya for the news in Kampala.